one by one they will get killed on this island. And then
hello my friends, welcome to Sharmishtha and Books. How are you all doing? I have been thinking of separating my channel for my bilingual viewers so that you can get English videos on the English channel and Bengali videos on the Bengali channel. I think the bilingual structure of my channel is making my viewers confused, and until I separate my channel, I want to keep throwing two or three English videos once in a while. If I create any kind of inconvenience for you, I'm really sorry, extremely sorry. But I want to keep rolling and keep the structure going before I separate the channel. So if you are here for Bengali videos, please check my other videos. I have different dedicated playlists for each language where I have separated all my English and Bengali videos so that you can find your preferred recommendations there. Today's video is really special because after a long time, I am finally being able to make this video, and it's a rainy day. And I thought, why not make a video dedicated to rainy day reading? So I'm going to recommend some books which are ideal if you want to read something on this cozy rainy day. You know, after tolerating this week-long heat wave in India, I think this rain is a solace to us. And I find reading mystery, thriller and horror spooky books really, really cozy during this time. And that is why I have carefully curated some of my favorite books from the genres I have mentioned earlier. And I think these books will go really well with the rainy day reading mode. So without further ado, let's get started. The first book I have here is The Kids Book of Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. This is the last story collection of Sherlock Holmes, and this is surprisingly dark, even darker than the previous books. And the stories are really unique. It's not repetitive, and I think read like 150 or 60 pages, like 6 or 7 short stories, and I am really hooked with each and every plot line. And the most amazing thing is this book has narration by Sherlock Holmes himself. In those previous writings, we have seen Dr. Watson being the narrator of these events and stories and adventures. But here, Sherlock Holmes has written one tale. I don't know if there are other tales written by him as well. But his narration is really different from Dr. Watson, because Watson puts a lot of emotional element in the book because he's a very nice man. But on the other hand, our Holmes is a sociopath. He is antisocial and he is often rude and brutally honest. And it's very, very fun to see him narrate story to the readers, because I find it very fascinating. I have only one complaint about Sherlock Holmes. I think the recurring theme of racism is a bit uncomfortable and really makes my reading experience sour. But it's there, always there in Sherlock Holmes tales. I have seen it earlier as well. But this is the only thing that bugs me when I read Sherlock Holmes. But I'm all for the dark side of London, the criminal world, and the way Sherlock Holmes deal with his villain. I think their rivalries with Sherlock Holmes are presented really well in this book. The theme is very gory, and they will remind you of Moriarty. They will remind you of the cunningness, the violence of Moriarty's mind. And I was really fascinated because each and every story gets darker. And the back of this Collins Classics edition says, "The disillusionment and disenchantment felt in the 1920s is reflected in the darker mood of many of the stories, and many believe that the author's developing interest in spiritualism influenced the themes he chose to explore." I think the visual element of violence and horror is also much more graphic in these stories than the previous ones. So if you're a fan of Sherlock Holmes, I say you should definitely pick this up for this any day. My next recommendation is a horror, and it's We Have Always Lived in the Castle by Shirley Jackson. I have become a huge fan of Shirley Jackson after reading this book because it's such a queer, weird story. It's about this girl whose entire family was murdered and they were poisoned, and she's the suspect. Like, she has killed her own father, mother, and other people, and only she and her elder sister and a cat and their uncle, who is disabled because of the poisoning, only these people are alive. And there is a sense of discomfort, there is a sense of spookiness, but you can't really point out what it is. That's the brilliance of this writing, and it's not just the horror element of it. This book beautifully depicts the pretension of people who try to act nice to each other, but deep inside they're all selfish beings. It just brings out the raw side of human existence and the crudity and the brutality of human behavior. From the very beginning, this girl is an unreliable narrator. You can't trust any word she says, but you will get weirdly fascinated and hooked by her narrative. This book is a vibe. This is definitely a rainy day vibe. And this spooky castle they live in, which is almost crumbling after the incident, and they don't take care of the house and they don't meet people socially. They are isolated in their own house. I don't want to riddle much because this book is going to take you on a very weird, adventurous and fascinating but slow-paced ride, which is so absorbing that you will forget your real time. I think this is worth a try. My next pick is Mexican Gothic by Silvio Moreno Gracia. I have been recommending this book again and again on my channel. I don't know, from the first day I have finished reading it, because this is such a great gothic book and it does gothic so well, and it is a brilliant study of gender and class politics. I think this is the perfect book for rainy day, and the atmospheric vibe of this book is, oh my god, it's unparalleled. You have to read this one. The story deals with Noemi. Noemi gets a letter from her sister that her husband is trying to poison her, and he asks for help from Noemi, and Noemi goes to this haunted mansion, a palace which belonged to her sister's husband's family, and this house is haunted. This is not about some ghost or spirit. It's a very complicated and complex psychological horror. The way the story is narrated, we get enchanted in the narrative, and I can remember the times I have forgotten that I am not Noemi, I'm not there, because I was so absorbed in the narration and the way the suspense and climax hit you. It's just another level. It gets you really, really absorbed, sucked into this haunted gothic vibe of this mansion, and the dampness, the darkness, the mystery of the setting will fit really well with a rainy day. So I think you should definitely pick this one. Just talking about this book makes me want to read it again. It's so good. Next, I have And Then There Were None by Agatha Christie. If you want to pick a book by Agatha Christie on a rainy day, I think this is the perfect book for you. This book deals with 10 guests who are mysteriously invited by an unknown host to a very far island, and one by one they will get killed for their past crimes. The crimes they have committed in the past were not prosecuted by the government at the time. They escaped law, but now they have to pay, and one by one they will get killed on this island. And there is no host. No one is there except two servants, a man and his wife, who were also invited to work there. None of these people has seen their host, who has invited them to kill them one by one. And from the cover, you can see it is dark. And let me show you the end papers. The weather is really gloomy. Heavy rain is falling and nobody has a clue who is murdering them. And every person is suspecting other, and they are scared to death that who is gonna be the next. So I really love Agatha Christie. She never disappoints me. And if you are going to read her writing for the first time, I think this one is a very safe choice. I think this book will determine whether you like her or not. A storyline is so unique, it was never done before. And I think it's one of those rare books where Agatha Christie combines mystery and thriller so well that you forget the difference of genre. It's good. Next, I have a thriller, and the thriller is The One. It's by John Mars, and I'm not a very big fan of contemporary thriller. If it doesn't have any literary value, I don't really enjoy a thriller because I find them repetitive sometimes. But the concept of this book is so unique that I couldn't stop myself from picking this up. I was not disappointed. This is a great, great example of thriller done right. So in this book, there is a company, there is an app and website that claims that they can find your soulmate through your DNA match, and there is only one person who is made for you, and through matching your DNAs, they can find you the right person for yourself. So you can imagine why the title is named The One. This book deals with five such matches, and one of them is a match of a serial killer with a police officer who is actually investigating the homicide. So you can see it's interesting from the very beginning. We are going to follow the lives of these five matches, and each chapter deals with one match, one case. Initially, you may feel that these are stories about different people, but once you reach the climax, everything and everyone is connected. And that twist blew my mind. Such a great read, and I have finished it within a day. It's not a very short book. It's 400 pages long, but it felt like I have been reading a 50 pages long short story collection, and I have been reading for only 1 hour because it's damn good. It's a page turner, and if you are on a reading slump and you really want to pick a book on this cozy rainy day, pick this one. You are not gonna get disappointed, I promise you. I have another thriller recommendation. I don't have a physical copy of this book, The Silent Patient. I think if you are a fan of thriller genre, you have probably read this one or heard about this book. It's a great book. I have given it 3.5 stars because I have guessed the culprit in the middle of the book, and it's not a good experience, but I think it was my instinct. It has nothing to do with the writing. The book didn't actually hint it towards the culprit, but I just guessed it, and it has nothing to do with the book's credibility. Coming back to the plot, the story is narrated by a psychiatrist, and he is going to meet a patient, a silent patient, a woman who has murdered her husband, and she has been silent from that day. There are various psychiatrists or psychologists who tried to make her speak or cure her, but they couldn't make her speak, and she was silent until this man arrived, and he's a great psychiatrist, and he tries to break her silence. And the atmosphere of this mental hospital is very gloomy, it's depressing, and also very mysterious. And through this narrator, we get to see this woman's past life as well, because he's researching on her and how she murdered her husband in the first place. I'm gonna stop here and not reveal anything more, because you have to discover the twist. It's worth it. Now we are going to talk about my favorite genre, that is classic, and I have two recommendations here. One is Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. Why not? This book has more bad stormy weather, heavy rainfall, a mysterious house owner Heathcliff, and his new tenant goes to meet Heathcliff, and he tries to be friend with him, but he gets no encouragement from the other side, and the people of the house, they don't talk to each other. It's not clear what their relationships are. It's very, very mysterious, and it just makes Mr. Lockwood, the new tenant, very intrigued by their lives, and he starts digging their past and try to figure out who they are and what happened to them, why they're like this. It's brilliantly done. And if you are a beginner who wants to read classic, I would always recommend this book, because this has the right amount of plot and suspense to keep you hooked, as well as there are so many topics which are discussed here, but not very critically, not in a very academic, philosophical way, if you know what I mean. It's just very simply told, but the layer of meaning is deep, but you have to figure it out. And the character of the villain is so good, and he is just the pure evil, though he has motivation, but I have always found him very fascinating as a villain who has zero empathy for anyone. It's so rare to see someone like this. Most of the time people are greedy and they have some kind of remorse. This man has zero remorse. It's just astounding to see someone like this. And all the other characters, they are not human. They are very ghost-like. If you read this book, you will understand that they are very unreal. You will feel like these people, these characters have come from very dark fairy tales. And this is the perfect pick for the stormy, rainy weather. And it will just enhance your reading experience. That's all I'm saying. And my last recommendation is Christina Rossetti's poetry collection. This is from Everyman's Library. This is their Pocket Poets edition, but you can also find different editions in paperbacks as well. And if you are a beginner who wants to read Christina Rossetti's work, I would recommend you The Goblin Market, because it's such a great rewriting of a fairy tale which deals with gender discrimination, sexual oppression, and homosexuality. If you are familiar with Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream, this book has those familiar elements of fairy and goblins and all those things, but it is darker. It has darker theme, and it's a narrative poetry, not a drama. But if you want to explore more of her work, I think this collection is really great. Most of her work was destroyed by her brother, who is also a very famous poet and painter, T.G. Rossetti. And he did this because there are many poems about Rossetti and her lover, who is also a woman. So her brother tried to bury her homosexual relationship with a woman. In doing so, he has done a huge crime and a disservice to literature. I get so furious every time I think about this incident, but whatever is left is gold. And I really love her style of writing. In this selection, you will see a lot of short poems as well. So it's good for people who don't usually read poetry, but her poems have many gothic elements, many fairy tale like elements, themes with death and everything, because she suffered a lot because of her health problems from her childhood. And most of her writings are very gloomy, and I specifically feel like reading gloomy writing, gloomy poetry during this season, so I would recommend this one. That's all for today, guys. I hope you have found your perfect pick for this rainy day. And if you have, please subscribe to my channel and show your support and love. I will be really grateful to you. And stay tuned. I will soon come with new announcements, new concept, new videos. Please share this video with your friends and family, and read a lot of books. Stay safe and enjoy this beautiful rainy season. Ta-da!